Przed rozpoczęciem przygotowań do sezonu 2022-2023 gruchnęła informacja o tym, że w nowych rozgrywkach zespołu Kolejorza nie będzie już mógł poprowadzić trener Maciej Skorża, który z powodów osobistych musiał zrezygnować ze stanowiska. Rozpoczęcie przygotowań do tego sezonu przebiegło jednak zgodnie z planem pod wodzą jego dotychczasowego asystenta Rafała Janasa. Równolegle jednak trwały poszukiwania szkoleniowca, który przejmie stery w zespole Kolejorza i ta misja właśnie dobiegła końca. Nowym trenerem Lecha Poznań został holenderski szkoleniowiec John van den Brom, który jest dzisiaj naszym gościem. Good evening, coach.
Hello,
welcome,
good evening.
Welcome in our team.
Thank you.
And I know you're only here for a few hours in yeah. Poznań, and I'm wondering if something surprised you so far, apart from the weather.
Yeah, the weather is... It was very hot today, but yeah, actually yesterday in Holland was also 32 degrees, so it was okay, but here it's much warmer. But yeah, I just arrived and I meet some, they bring me to the hotel, and after that we came here to do some things with you. And hopefully at the end we go inside to the stadium. I would like to see that.
Okay, let's go to football. And I know as a football coach, you probably get used to this thing that when you're coming to the new club, you're always replacing somebody. Yeah. But usually it's like the team is struggling and yeah. have not so good results. But here in Lech Poznań, situation is different. Like we 1 month ago, we became Polish champions with coach that was adored by the fans. But he had to yeah. go out because of the personal reasons.
Yes.
And I'm wondering if this situation changed something with your approach and if this situation will make this your entrance to the team a bit harder.
No, not harder. First of all, I would like to say respect to the other coach, the results what he made. Of course, the champion is very important for him, but for the players, for the team, but most of all for the fans. And he did a great job, and on personal reason he stopped working in the club, and that's why they came to me. And of course for me it's a big opportunity when you can work with the champion of Poland. You can play the qualification for the Champions League, but very important also, you can start as a new coach in a new club. Everything is new for me again. Of course I was in Poland, because in football it's a small world. But yeah, now you start working in a different country. But the most important thing for me is that I start working at the beginning of the season. I know they already start with training, but we have some time to prepare the team for the very important games, what starts on the 5th of July. So that is the best part. And what you said is correct. Normally, some club is looking for a coach because they are not satisfied, or the coach go to a better club maybe. This is new situation, but for me, I think it's very, very good moment to start in a new club.
But as you said, we had really little time to our first game yeah. in the Champions League qualifications, like only 3 weeks left. And I'm wondering if it's enough time to get to know the team well for this game.
Of course, in football is also, it's not, I was speaking since maybe 10 days with the club. So I see many games, most of all from last year. I don't see the game of yesterday to introduce the players for myself. But in football it's also easy. If you work together with players, and it's pre-season, so we're going to train hard, we're going to train a lot. And that is the best way to remember the players in my mind. And of course I already have an idea in the way of play, but also with the players were last year here.
And you have already an idea how to convince players to your vision of football in
yes.
such a small period of time?
Yes, I speak a lot of time with people of the board. Speak with Thomas, of course, the technical director, but also with the president, with a lot of board meetings. Last week I was one day here. It was a little bit secret, but now I can say. So we speak a lot about this kind of things, to prepare the team, many games in short time. But yeah, first of all, it's important that we are ready on the 5th of July against Karabakh.
I'm sure before making decision to accept the job, you try to do as much as you can to get to know our team
yes.
well. You told that you didn't watch our yesterday's game.
Not yet.
But you probably see some replays from last season. And yeah. what you can say, tell us, what do you know already about Lech team? What can you tell us?
And when a club asks you maybe to be the coach, you're gonna watch some video games. You're gonna watch some way of playing, and that is my the most important thing. And in the speaking moment that we have with the club, with the board, yeah, it was very important for me to understand and to hear, to listen the vision, my philosophy of football, if it's compared with the club, and yeah, that's why they came to me. So in that way, we're gonna play normally the same way of playing what we always do here in the club. That's my way of playing also, my vision, my idea. Of course, I came from Holland, and everybody knows in Holland it's offensive way of playing. That is very important. This is what the team can, what they do already. So in this case, it's actually a little bit easy for me to work with the players.
Before our conversation, I looked for some links between you and Polish football, and there are not many of them, but there are a few. For example, Aaron Johansson, who recently played in Lech Poznań, and he was your player at Alkmaar. Or for example, your former assistant coach Besnik Hasi, who later on worked in Polish league. I'm wondering if you contacted them to know a bit about Lech, about Polish league?
No, the only player what I contact last week was Mickey van der Hart, the goalkeeper. He's left now, but of course it's easy for me to speak with him. We can speak in our own language. And he gave me some good information, not only about the team, also about the club, also about the city, the way of living, but also about the fans. So yeah, it was good to have a good conversation with him. About the most important for me was the team. What kind of team is it? What kind of players are it? And he was very positive about actually about everything. Of course, he was champion also, so it's easy for him. But it was good for me to hear that. And with the other guys, with Aaron or Besnik, I don't speak about it because it's a long time ago, and it's better to work and then to feel how it works. Because if you get a lot of information, everybody's try to put some pressure on you. That's not what I want. I start tomorrow with training, and then we will see what's going to happen and how it works. It's better for me.
You already told us a bit about your vision of football that is offensive and so on. But could you tell us something more? What type of Lech we could expect under your leadership?
What I like is a team what controlling the game. And if you can control the game, most of the time you have more ball possession than the other teams. That's where it starts. So I always thinking about ball possession. And of course, we have to do the right things on the right moment. This is important. Also important for me is organization. Organization in the pitch. So everybody knows, everybody has to understand what is his job on his position. And if you can bring this all together, that makes a strong team. And I'm a team player. I'm not doing it because I'm the coach and I'm the boss. I do it by myself. No way. Don't worry for that. All the people in the club, even the media team, we are one team. We have one idea about football, one idea about how we can be successful in the next couple of years. And yeah, that's my job, and I love to be a part of that.
I'd like to go for a moment to your football player career, and I know you are a legend of Vitesse, but you also played in Ajax Amsterdam, and you worked with coach Louis van Gaal.
Yes.
And that's for sure one of the best coaches in Holland's history, and he's still working. He's working with national team of Netherlands. And I'm wondering if when you made this decision that you want to become a coach, he was like some kind of role model for you, and if so, what did you take from him?
Oh, first of all, it was great to work on him as a player. That in 93-95, I was playing from Ajax, and we win the Champions League in 95. Everybody knows that. Mr. Van Gaal was the coach, a role model for me as a player, and because I already knows that I want to be a coach also. So I learned a lot of him. I learned a lot about his trainings, situations, trainings, exercise. Also the way how he prepare the team, how he works with players individually. So yeah, from that moment we still have contact, and that is good. And if you see him now he is more than 70 years, But he is still the same Louis van Gaal as the time that I work with him. And yeah, I've a lot of respect for him. And of course, he's a top coach, but he is always taking care of his principles. And this is the way he wants to do it. And he always continue. And he never make like go to the left, to the right. No, always straight forward. And yeah, that's what I really like.
Looking for some information about you, I read some Dutch Holland expert about your time in Alkmaar, yeah. when you were working there, that this team was playing the best football in Eredivisie. That was his opinion, and the same opinion I read about your period in Genk in Belgium. Yeah. So that's what we should expect expect here. And how much important for you is this, let's say, prettiness of football your team is playing?
No, I love football. I love football, and my job is that the fans in the stands, in the tribunes, they really like to see our team. And of course, the result is most of all the most important thing. But if you win the games with lovely football, with nice actions, with good crosses, with the team spirit, all this kind of thing, that's what I like. And it's my job to bring that here also. As a coach to the players, and I also really like to work with young players, with talent players, talentful players. Everybody knows in Poland that we have a great academy, so that's why I speak what I speak about last week also. And yeah, if we have good players, just please bring them to the first team and let them show. And yeah, I give them time to improve themselves, but I also give options that they can show it, not only for me, for the team, but also for the fans. And we play for something, we play for winning, but the way we want to play, that is, for sure, because I already saw, and I know we have good players, that is gonna be a big part of my job as a coach.
That was actually the next question I wanted to ask about these young players, but let's stick with this question. Yuri Tielemans, Dries Mertens, Nasser Chadli, that's only only short bit of the players you worked with when they were young. Yes. And that's impressive, that, like, every Polish fan knows these players. And we got a lot of young players knocking to the first team door as well here in Lech Poznań. So we should expect more and more of them in our team under your leadership.
No, but first of all, the club, they have to bring these players. Eh? It's not my job in the academy. They have to improve them to the first team. And the only thing what I can do is give them opportunities, give them chances to show the qualities. But if they are really talentful, 100% sure they're gonna change or they're gonna get chances from me. And of course, the names you told me, everybody knows these guys, but even when they are 18 years old, even Yuri Tielemans, he make his debut when I was the coach in Anderlecht, he was 16 years. I don't worry for ages. I see, hey, if he is good enough, it's always my rule. If he's good enough, he is old enough. So if they bring young guys here, and what I heard from Mr. Thomas, he told me, even now in the training camp, he brings some young guys, and I'm looking forward to see them. Absolutely.
Another popular topic in summertime is, of course, transfer window. Yeah. And we all know that Lech Poznań will do some transfer in next following weeks. And I'm wondering if you will have some impact of which players will come, or is it too late for it?
Too late?
Yeah.
No, it has to start already. the window is still the 1st of September, so we have time enough. First of all, I think it's important for me to learn the players, to see if we have some position in the team where we can be better. And this is what we discussed with the board of the club also last Monday. But for now, I think we're gonna do something, but yeah, we have time enough. Don't worry for time in football. And time is the worst thing you can do, because working every day with the players, and sometimes a player came up that we didn't expect, so in a new coach, so give them time, give them opportunities, and even then we watch for the window.
Okay, so we know something about your past, about your vision of football. So let's talk about what's here and now. You're starting on Monday with the start of our training camp, and you're bringing with you one assistant coach.
Yes.
And it's a well-known name in Poland. It's Dani Lanzat, very good player, international player.
Yes.
And I'm wondering what type of coach he is, and have you already worked together?
Yes, I have worked 2 times with him, of course. We play together, small period, but a long time ago. And after that, when I arrived in Alkmaar, in AZ, he was also part of the coaching staff in the first team. And so we worked there. And the last period in when small time in Saudi Arabia, I bring him also. And there I learn, if I see the potential of Dani, and the quality of Dani is not only tactically, he can give good training session. He can be part of the group because he's still young. He's fit. He's very, very, very good. Let me say that in working with young players, to do some extra with them, to give them confidence, to be sometimes be a more father role. Hey, come here, my son. We're gonna train. Don't worry, it's coming. All this kind of thing. So. Of course, as a coach, you are the manager, but it's very important that you can bring somebody in. And yeah, I work very good with Dani 2 times already, and I'm happy that he came also tomorrow.
At the same time, you are going to work with part of coaching staff that played, that worked with coach Mr. Skorża. And is it because it will make easier for you to get to know the team and league and so on, because they played with this team for a year?
I really don't like it to bring a whole new stuff in the club, because it's never working. I never do that. The maximum people that I bring in is only one. So I bring my assistant and the rest, because what I heard from Thomas, what I heard from the president, they have a lot of quality.
Yep.
And this is the most important. If they are good, okay, we continue to working. And it's also important for me, because I'm new. Of course, I don't know the Polish competition so good right now, and everybody can help me in that. But first of all, what I heard is that they have a lot of quality.
Yeah, that's the thing I want to mention, because you've never worked outside of this, let's call it Benelux circle, like Belgium or Netherlands, with this small job in Saudi Arabia, in the Middle East. And is it this short amount of time, like 3 weeks only, enough time to prepare the team for playing Polish league when you don't know the league so well?
No, it's not difficult. No. Because, and that is what I try to explain, the philosophy of working, my philosophy of working, my philosophy of training. And I think it's comparing with the team. And of course, I have to find it out, well, how it works in the league. But yeah, first of all, let me work with the players, and even then I can see what kind of players I have. And if you see some videos, or maybe you're gonna watch some games live also, because I like to see games, it's then you get a good opinion about the Polish league. And overall, I have a very complete staff, and they know everything about it, so they can help me also. They have to help.
Yeah. On the other hand, you have a lot of experience in European Cup competitions, and that's what we need, because we need to find a way to play at the same time in the league, in the Polish Cup, and in the European competitions.
So we have a lot of games. Actually, after every 3-4 days, we have to play from beginning of July till maybe the end of October, something like that. And there's only a break in September. That's what they told me, international break. For the rest, games. So yeah, it's you cannot do it with only the first 11. We need more players. Now they bring more players for me. We have good players, and yeah, we have to use it. So it's not an option to play from the beginning till the end with only the first 11. It's no option.
Okay, coach. So I think we know a lot about you already. So thank you for your time, and we wish you good luck with our team. And we cannot wait to see the effects of your work here. So
I cannot wait also. So I'm really happy to be here. Absolutely.
A Państwu dziękuję serdecznie za oglądanie i tradycyjnie zapraszam na kolejne produkcje w Lech TV. Zapraszam również do subskrybowania naszego kanału i oglądania. Dziękuję, do zobaczenia.